Hey guys, today we are going to talk about Penguinz0. So I had no idea, but he lives in Florida. I think when you Google it, it comes to Tampa, Florida. So hopefully Charlie is okay. He does have a massive Magic the Gathering and Pokemon collection. So hopefully those are okay as well. And of course, obviously himself. So I'm going to read you some statements. It can be argued that Charlie is as critical as Karl. So why sue Karl Jobst when Charlie lives in the same exact state as you? He's actually asking to be sued, and he's made some very critical statements about you. Is this really about Apollo Legend? Now, Charlie, he wasn't around when he wasn't commenting on this situation when Apollo Legends. Rest in peace. And it was only Karl Jobst, to my knowledge. So I did look at Moist Critical. I did look at archives. He is on Twitch, so there is possibility that there might be a stream, and it wasn't really recorded. But to my knowledge, he actually does not talk about Charlie at all, or Charlie does not talk about Apollo Legend at all, and he may not even have been aware about the Apollo Legend situation. So is this really about Apollo Legends or is it about something else? Because if it's about something else, right, wouldn't he sue? Why travel to Australia where the Australian law is significantly different and it's harder to win? And if you do lose, you have to pay your lawyer fees and then Carlos' lawyer fees. Wouldn't it be more interesting or easier, so you don't have to travel, or you literally are going to like the furthest place away from Florida to sue someone who's asking to be sued? Okay, so let's read some of the things that Charlie has said. I mean, in my opinion, these things are not worse than what Carl has said regarding Donkey Kong. Now, Charlie has not really mentioned Apollo Legend, so there that might be the difference. But at least as to cheating in Donkey Kong situation, I would think that this guy is even more aggressive than Carl Jobst. And easier of a litigant. Now, people in the comments have told me, oh, it's because Charlie has a lot of money. Moist Critical has a lot of money. But in the US, he's probably going to pay for his own legal fees. So, yes, he has a lot of money. But if your idea is to make a point, it would be a lot easier to do so with somebody who's in the same state as you, especially for defamation. So let's read some of the statements from Charlie. I'd like to start by addressing all the individuals on Twitter that have been spamming me today, demanding I give Billy Mitchell an apology. This is my official response to all of you. And it was him farting into the microphone. Almost fell off the chair on the way down. Billy Mitchell does not deserve an apology because Billy Mitchell is not innocent. You are letting him manipulate and lie to you, as he has done his entire career. I don't think he's even able to accidentally tell the truth about anything. If a single truthful statement left the lips of Billy Mitchell, he'd probably be set on fire instantly, smited by the Lord, his whole core being, his soul is entwined with his lies. And you could even make this argument, and I would make this argument, that he has a bigger reach than Karl Jobst because he had more subscribers. He does Twitch, right? So if you are worried about defamation, wouldn't this be the guy you would come after? Like, why would you come after Karl Jobst in Australia? Now, having reviewed all of the material that is public to me, again, I don't know how many times I have to say it. There is material private, like Karl Jobst's offer from settlement in 2022 that no one knew. I didn't know that. You guys didn't know that. That was private. And that number that was offered to settle, no one knows. And rightfully so, right? But even in the comment section, right, it is pretty bad. So if you are worried about your reputation and you're worried about defamation, then I hate to say it because each defamation case is unique, but maybe there's an easier, readily available, willing target in Charlie, more critical, and he has the money to fight it. So is that a consideration? Why not? You know, this is also very interesting about defamation. And Logan Paul, we're going to take a small side. Why go after CoffeeZilla when so many other channels similar size to CoffeeZilla went reported on the same crypto zoo, right? Everyone, you know, from Attorney Tom, right? He's got a million plus subscribers. He went after, he's actually supposedly suing. Was it Attorney Tom? It was some attorney online who's actually leading a class action lawsuit against Logan Paul on crypto zoo. It's interesting. And then here is another quote. He is desperate now. From Moist Critical, and over the years, he's made a habit out of suing anybody who even so much as mentions him and cheating in the same sentence. Meanwhile, for the last few years, I have directly called him a cheater, and I received nothing. Billy, where's my present from Santa Claus? Where is your little, fresh, blanking, pitiful lawsuit? I don't know why he refuses to engage in a legal battle with me when he's so happy to do it with everyone else. And that's kind of interesting, right? Because when something is reported, like I take, again, Logan Paul's example, CryptoZoo, a lot of people reported on CryptoZoo. So why is CoffeeZilla being the only one being sued? So a lot of people reported on the alleged cheating allegations of Billy Mitchell. Why is Karl being sued and why not? And that's making sense. And the general conception would be, oh, Karl's a bigger YouTuber. He has bigger reach. You got a guy sitting here asking to be sued, and he is much larger in terms of overall reach than Karl. And yet, you don't sue him, and he's literally in the backwoods of your neighborhood. Like, he's literally in the same state, Florida, as you. Is it because he's afraid of Moist Critical? But, like, even so, like, you know, his YouTube channel is not very big, and I don't know how big his other social media is. Like, I found it, and it doesn't seem, maybe he's like a TikToker or something I don't know of. But Billy Mitchell isn't someone who has a large social media following, at least online, visibly. It is strange that he would sue Karl Jobst and not sue if he was worried about the size of the following. If you give him anything under 5 stars, you're faced with a lawsuit at your door the next day. Why does he keep claiming to be the ultimate gamer ever? Brother, that's not what he's claiming. Are you not listening? He's the video game player of the century, not the ultimate gamer. That's a totally different title, which he could have easily gotten if he wanted to, but he was too effing busy blanking your mom in every other goddamn groupie that was on his meat after he got the Donkey Kong record, so now he settled for just being a video gamer of the century, and thanks heavens for that. If he went for the ultimate gamer too, there'll be no woman left for the rest of us. Is it the tone? Maybe it's the tone. So it looks like Moist Critical is kind of sarcastic and a little bit over the top, while Karl Jobst is more factual, right? He's presenting it as factual. It would be more difficult to sue Moist Critical because of that element. And in defamation, you need to, at least in the U.S., again, if you sued Moist Critical, they're both public figures, you would have to prove malice or reckless intent. And this doesn't really seem like malice to me. I don't know the malice stand. I've been told various things in the comment section, and take it with a grain of salt. But my understanding in Australia, from what I've read myself, is that malice isn't something that matters in Australia. So malice really matters against public figures in the U.S. because now you can be wrong. You can say Tom Brady loves FTX. You could be wrong and you could prove, oh, you know, I didn't like it. But as long as you didn't say it with the idea of malice or reckless intent or recklessness, you're okay. So you can make mistakes on public figures. People do all the time where something is, you know, and right now I'm seeing that a lot of people are making videos about Caitlin Clark going to Europe and then like forgoing the WNBA. To my knowledge, that's not true, but a lot of people are saying it and pretending that it's true. So they do get the viewership up, right? They're getting millions of views under this false pretense and where there's no information otherwise, because they're trying to stir the pot of the WNBA mistreating Caitlyn, which is true. So there is a large audience for this consumption of this information, but overall, it is not verified. There's no word from Caitlyn. In fact, Caitlyn seems to be happy with the WNBA. So there are people posting false narratives online, and they're not, they are doing it with, for whatever reason, but it's hard to prove malice. It really is hard to prove malice. Yeah, and he's got, he's got multiple streams. He has, I guess that doing this was a fast effect in Magic the Gathering, because after that, even though BB had clearly declared he had nothing further, he was then allowed to resume questioning Charlie again without any objection. So, I don't know. Let me know what it is. Is it really Apollo Legend? That's the only difference I can see. I can't really see any other difference, right? Because if anyone was critical of him, I wouldn't say one is more critical than the other, but I would say it's pretty close. I would definitely say it's pretty damn close, right? In terms of who said what about Billy Mitchell and whether or not it was offensive to Billy Mitchell. It's a great testimony. People think it's not funny. I think it's not the judge in the court. You know, it's all about decor. So if you've ever gone to court, which I've had to go recently, you know it's all about decor, right? It's all about everyone dresses the best they can. The judge has, you know, sometimes a wig on, depending on what country you go to. And it's all about, you know, to enter a fart, you know, to enter a literal fart into evidence and have a judge sit there, have the audience listen to the fart, and then to discuss the fart is beyond me. I mean, only most critical. And then to have, like, the guy, to have Billy Mitchell on Skype, or whatever program they're using, on video conferencing call, have to listen to Moist Critical respond by farting at him is, it's something else. I think people take court sometimes too seriously. I know, I believe this judge was not too amused, because all this is on record, and should it be appealed? Like, people forget this, right? This is just the trial. This can be appealed. Like, one of the biggest dangers in not settling is that even if you win, you can get appealed. No one ever talks about that part, but that's kind of important here, no? Anyway, let me know what you guys think. Bye, guys.